We're here and ready for action on another Monday Night Raw.
I can't wait to get things kicked off. I've heard we've got some amazing matches in store.
I'm excited as well, despite having to sit next to you, Saxton. That's how good this show's gonna be.
Here comes the man.
The WWE Universe on its feet for Becky Lynch.
Now we're talking. Yeah.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making her way to the ring from Dublin, Ireland, Becky Lynch.
Yeah, the man never stops running her mouth, but she's got a bad habit of backing it up.
One of the most determined competitors in all of WWE.
Yeah, Becky Lynch began her career as the last kicker, and now Becky Lynch is simply the man. Here comes a powerhouse blonde bombshell.
And from Yorktown Heights, New York, Mandy Rose.
One of the top competitors in the women's tag division.
How about the storybook romance that Mandy Rose had with Otis?
I'd rather forget those days, Saxton.
Why? It was true love. No doubt the highest profile win for Mandy Rose when she defeated her former partner Sonya Deville in a loser leaves WWE match at SummerSlam.
Becky Lynch out here to prove she has no complacency. She has no lack of drive, doesn't care what she's accomplished. It's always about the next step.
And then you have someone like Mandy Rose. I mean, there's no one like Mandy Rose, but you know what I mean. Physically dominant from her strength to her looks.
Yeah, Mandy certainly has an understated, almost effortless approach to her strength and power game. Ooh, refusing to let her get into her head. Stomping.
Ouch.
Mandy keeps her at bay. Here we go! Exploder suplex!
Schoolboy! Wait, no!
Into a powerbomb!
Oh, and Rose denies the attack.
Taking a moment to let her know who the real superstar is here.
Boom! Nice!
Suplex.
Cover.
Kicks out of the pinfall attempt.
She likely knew that wasn't enough. She's just keeping the pressure on.
And Lynch here. Corey, what do you think Becky has her mindset on doing in this match?
Well, we all know Becky has an affinity for taking people's arms, and I don't see why she'll have any change of heart tonight.
Are we gonna see a tap?
This is her time to shine, and don't you forget it.
Timely reversal on Lynch. Snap suplex. Mandy lining her up from the top turnbuckle.
From the top.
Giving the people a chance to take in her undeniable greatness.
Carefully placed stomp to the arm.
Uh-oh.
Liv saw it coming.
She can end it here.
One, two.
Manages to escape before the three count.
No celebrations yet.
Mandy Rose with the instinct to counter. Sit out, Matt Slam. Face first with a waistlock takedown. She had it scouted. Oh, no. Someone called the orthodontist.
Hazardous situation for Lynch.
Two.
And she reaches the rope, breaking the pin attempt. Able to get the advantage here. Going right to the kidneys.
Golly.
It is up. Can she do it here?
One, two,
and she fights it off.
Somehow she's still in this matchup. It's unbelievable.
Yikes, that'll either wake you up or knock you out.
You can sense what her intentions are here.
Oh, she misses the mark. Things not going how she'd like.
This is where endurance becomes so important in the late stages of the match. Inverted DDT.
Two.
Mandy keeps her at bay.
Hammerlock. Reverse DDT.
Three.
And a kick. Spinning kick to the gut. Showing no restraint.
This is Becky coming for more than just an arm. Lynch is coming for every piece of her.
Heads outside, but this one has to end in the ring. She gets Becky with a counter.
Mandy might be able to start mounting something here.
Good chance for her to gain her wits about her.
Three.
She heads out, but this one can be lost by count out.
How insulting is that? Roses.
Cover.
Two.
Got it. No, just a two.
What a match.
Oh, Mandy right to the face. Mandy's just about to finish this.
Cover.
Two. It wasn't enough. She kicked out.
Becky is alive. The fire is still burning. You come at the man, you'll have to come harder than that.
I don't know if there's more frustration or desperation in the ring now, knowing that you tried to end this and failed. You can sense it. This crowd is on pins and needles.
The WWE Universe is ready to erupt. Are we close to the beginning of the end?
Nice takedown by Becky, looking for the armor. It's in. Disarmor. I can't believe she's hanging on this long.
She's got a tap.
No escape, only surrender. Becky's opponent's fit.
Put it in the books. Becky Lynch wins.
This superstar picks up a huge victory here tonight. Much deserved, Michael.
Got to be humiliated and embarrassed. One of the most inspirational superstars around.
One of my personal favorites. Oh! almost a superhero, Nikki A.S.H.
How appropriate, Saxton, because you're almost a commentator.
That wasn't funny, Corey.
The following contest is a triple threat match. Making her way to the ring, from Glasgow, Scotland, almost a superhero, Nikki A.S.H.
Listen, guys, I'll admit it. The change in attitude recently has brought Nikki A.S.H. a lot of success.
Wait, Corey, does that mean you're ready to jump on the bandwagon of Nikki A.S.H.?
Absolutely not.
Well, the change in attitude of Nikki A.S.H. has certainly helped.
Now she's won the Money in the Bank, the Raw Women's Championship, and the Women's Tag Titles.
I think we're going to see even more of super heroics here tonight. Here comes the EST of WWE.
In her opponents, first, from Knoxville, Tennessee, the Raw Women's Champion, Bianca Belair.
Bianca's been exceptional her entire life. She earned all SEC and All-American honors in track and field at the University of Tennessee. And if you just ask her, she'll tell you why she's better than everybody else.
You got eyes, Byron. You understand. A freak in the weight room, a beast in the ring. Bianca Belair can do it all.
And she's got a lethal hair whip.
Here's one of the most dominant women superstars today, Rhea Ripley.
Australia, Rhea Ripley.
You know, Rhea Ripley's got to be the billboard example when it comes to stealing headlines in your debut. Remember, Rhea Ripley won the Raw Women's Championship on the grandest stage of WrestleMania.
Now, you're absolutely right, Byron. Rhea Ripley is not afraid of any competitor, no matter how impressive their resume may be.
Sent a message to the entire world in the 2017 and 2018 Mae Young Classic tournaments. And things getting started for these three in this triple threat match.
This one's going to test these superstars' creativity. It's going to take outside-of-the-box thinking to prevail against two of them.
Oh, just scrubbing the face on the canvas. Oh,
man. Oh, an elbow drop for added measure.
Oh, man,
right to the arm.
Hyperextend your elbow.
Oh, right across the throat.
She is really showing her confidence.
Suplex.
And Corey, a superstar's odds of winning in a triple threat match are significantly less than usual, correct?
Well, my Steiner math's a little rusty, but that is my general understanding. Yes, you need to be fully aware of your surroundings to keep your chances up.
There goes Ripley, sent to the outside hard.
Big time clothesline.
Good grief. Ooh, what a forearm claw. Taking a moment to get pumped off of this crowd's incredible energy.
Three.
And this might not have a pleasant ending.
Piercing the throat.
Oh, solid kick across the back.
Oh, look at this. Oh, pump handle. And a gut buster.
Nice.
Overhand right lands.
And Nikki didn't see that coming. Effects on her. She's only aggravating her competition at this point.
Neck breaker.
Oh, yeah. She's saying, let's go. Bring it.
Oh, it didn't go as planned there. Kick out before the one count.
She shows that she's far from finished. Feeding off the WWE Universe's energy.
Down and set up Spinebuster. That offense taking a toll on her. Punishing Congressman.
Multiple stops.
Two.
Broken, keeping the match alive.
It's not over yet.
Oh, right to the throat. Thrust to the throat.
Double flapjack.
Oh, my. Stomping down.
She's looking highly motivated, getting hyped up.
Trap. Precision strikes. The arm absorbing the damage. Ooh. Standing shooting star press. Incredible.
And Belair now gaining the advantage on Ripley.
Caught with a neck breaker. Makes the cover.
She got so close, she could taste it there.
And the DDT.
She might be in some trouble now.
Hanging tough as this match progresses. No easy task in a triple threat match.
Just hell-bent on finishing things right now.
Nikki sidesteps.
And back into the ring she goes. She's getting herself in the zone, but she shouldn't hesitate much longer. She could tear her opponent right here. And there's the breakup, just in the nick of time.
Right to the kidneys from behind.
From behind. Back suplex.
Strong takedown.
She's got the whole WWE Universe rallying behind her.
Pressure.
Nikki needs to reassert herself back in this match.
To the skies. Did Belair just close this out?
Looking for the victory.
Two.
Oh, dropped right across the neck. Flat out power.
Wow.
A deadlift military press.
Holy moly.
Slam.
Oh, yeah, she is really getting fired up.
She's starting to drag a little bit.
After lasting this long in a triple threat, it'd be a shame to take a nosedive now.
Boom, clothesline.
Two.
quickly put a stop to that. Oh, look at the knee strikes.
One after the other. Ripley has things right where she wants them. Here we go.
For the win.
I think we are witnessing a career-altering moment for these superstars, guys.
But the spoilers will only go to the victor. I have a feeling we're close to finding out exactly who that will be.
Oh, man, by the hair. Why is she still boasting around? She's in a fight, for goodness sake.
Hard shot to the back. Here's the pump handle.
Into the cover.
One, two.
Oh, kick out. How did she do that?
Getting out of that by the skin of their teeth.
Big plans in mind for the EST.
Oh, man.
Two.
Hooked up.
DDT. Shoulders down. Could she finally put this away?
Will it be? That could have been it right there. Stops Ripley's attack. This isn't going to be pretty. Hangman's neck break.
Gosh.
Ah, jeez. Right across the face. Hard landing.
She's going up.
Top rope here. And Bianca turning around.
Up high.
Solely focused on.
Three. Four.
Power slam. Here's the cover for the win. Running interference.
Firm control.
Oh, what a bump to the face! We are looking to end this one right now. This will do it. The Prism Trap is in. What's going to happen here? I think she's got an opportunity to turn this around. She just got to shift her body just a little bit to get out of this.
I don't know, Cole. It looks bleak.
And for some reason, she's going for it. This could be. Back into the ring.
Sure, this one was over.
Hit drop.
I'm a witness to that.
Belair being met with some stiff resistance down the stretch.
All Belair's work being broken down by the second. She's in some real trouble.
Enough already. If this works, it could change the course of the match.
She's getting back up, but she might be down again soon.
Up high.
And Bianca felt the full force of that.
There's two!
Gets it in! What a triple threat!
Sometimes a match can't live up to the hype, guys, but that one sure did.
Your winner, almost a superhero, Nikki A.S.H.
Impressively withstanding the onslaught of the two other superstars to stand tall and have their arm raised here and now.
I have to say, I'm just as impressed by this win as the WWE Universe. Triple threat matches are no joke.
From the underground of New York City, Damian Priest has arrived.
Calm demeanor, but about to unleash chaos.
pass.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from New York, New York, weighing in at 249 pounds, Damian Priest.
Damian Priest has a martial arts background, pure brawling power.
Scared of a fight. Not starting now.
Priest's rise is your demise. Beware the Archer of Infamy.
Make way for the Irish Ace.
This is gonna be good.
And his opponent, from Bray, County Wicklow, Ireland, weighing in at 180 pounds, he is the Irish Ace, Jordan Devlin.
This man began training at 12 years old. He was actually trained by Finn Balor.
Obviously, Balor taught him well, as this man owns the longest cruiserweight title reign in WWE history at 438 days.
Hey, he's got a big ego, all attitude.
But Jordan Devlin always backs it up in the ring. Confidence personified.
Damian Priest, a man that made his mark on the independents, is also a man known to indulge in the party scene.
Yeah, but it's not all late nights and rock and roll for Priest. Beneath his mysterious swagger is an all-consuming commitment to success. That experience on the independents has only sharpened Priest's abilities.
And those abilities have been enough to see the Archer of Infamy rising up the ranks. I expect that we'll get everything in his quiver from Priest here tonight.
And then there's Jordan Devlin, who draws a lot of comparisons to Finn Balor, though Jordan actually grew up idolizing Shawn Michaels. Devlin's taken off from both of the superstars' styles and made it his own.
And it's safe to say he's not afraid to make those comparisons. Devlin is one of the most confident superstars to come out of the UK scene that we've ever laid eyes on.
What does Jordan Devlin have to do tonight to walk away with the win?
Keep constant pressure. Devlin's best asset and worst enemy is his own confidence. He can't get too comfortable and make a critical mistake.
Uh-oh. Looking for a little bit of high risk here, it seems. Oh, my God. He misses the target.
Short flight, but a rough landing. Oh, look at the squeeze. It's on like a vice grip.
Oh, that just looks nasty.
This could do it. Kick out at one.
Doesn't bode well if you still can't get more than a one count by now.
From down below. Ouch.
And Devlin a little worse for wear there as his opponent goes to work.
Yeah, that's Priest's experience guiding him to an advantage.
Definitely not where you want to be right now. Just carried like a ragdoll here.
And over the top into a rough landing.
And he's taking this to the outside now.
Targeting the chest. Very effective.
Double underhook applied. Up and down. Glam slam. Free fall.
Okay, he's re-entering the ring. Moves outside. What's the plan here?
Oh, sent flying.
Consecutive attacks keeping Devlin off his game.
Yeah, Devlin needs to affirm himself back in this match.
Down,
glam slam, free fall. Priest gets countered.
Devlin's finally able to slow all that incoming offense.
Yeah, Jordan finding some fight and finally getting in some offense of his own.
And fate right now.
Heading back to the ring.
Big forearm.
Big blow. Could be felt throughout the arena.
Oh, my gosh.
And his eyes are piercing through the opposition now.
Priest dodges out of that.
Damian Priest has got him set up for the broken arrow.
There's the cover.
Close. That could have been it.
Priest has him lined up. Has it hooked. Hit the lights.
Priest has him on Dream Street.
Is it enough? One, the cover.
Two, three.
And that's all she wrote.
Now let's get another look at some of the high points of that one.
Your winner, Damian Priest.
Wrestle perhaps the perfect match. Never any doubt in this win.
As always, Cole, you're more polite than I am, so I'll just say what we're...
The original blow has arrived.
One of the coolest and one of the most confident competitors in all of WWE.
And Riddle's backed up that confidence thus far.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in at 216 pounds, Riddle.
Seems like everybody's got an opinion about Riddle, whose laid-back style has earned plenty of fans and detractors.
The flops are off, and that means Riddle is ready.
We're about to see a grappling clinic.
The Prince has arrived.
A decorated champion who has truly reinvented himself.
And his opponent from Bray, County Wicklow, Ireland, weighing in at 190 pounds, Finn Balor.
This is a man who is already one of the greatest NXT superstars in history, but truly cemented his legacy by returning and dominating as NXT champion once again.
Well, now he's set to dominate any roster that Finn Balor targets.
You know, I don't know if it's just me, or does Finn Balor just keep getting cooler every year?
Saxton, when it comes to being cool, you are one man I will never ask. You see the intense focus and drive in the eyes of Finn Balor.
When it comes to Finn Balor, it's always about competing at the highest of levels.
Changes in attitude may be controversial, but it's worth acknowledging one thing that has never changed for Balor, and that is appreciation of a good challenge. Balor loves being pushed to his limit, from his time in Japan to his tenure on multiple WWE brands.
Balor gives as well as he gets. An important part of his personality is to bring the best out of his opponents so they can bring the best out of him. Changing attitude didn't change that.
We should soon see just how much of a challenge Balor is up for tonight.
And staring him down is Riddle, the original bro.
Byron, I'll emphasize taking flight.
Anticipating Riddle. Float over.
Oh.
And with DDT.
Fight.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, my God.
No. Oh, that'll break his arm. Vicious.
Systematic attack on that arm.
He's got him scouted.
What are we going to see here?
Oh!
Thrown asleep!
German suplex! Off into the pin! And he has the shoulder up before two!
I can't believe the ref didn't get two here!
Climbing up to the top now!
Dropping down all their weight. Senton connects.
Balor retaliates. Flying forearm connects. The original bro taking some hits there. His ring style being nullified a bit. He can do it here. Surprisingly quick kick out.
These men knew this match was going to be hard fought.
What impact!
Oh, stomping away.
Oh.
Balor looking to close this one out.
Down 19-16.
Balor brought the fight there. The question is if his opponent
and Balor tied.
Did Balor secure a win?
These superstars put on quite a show. Here's another look.
Here is your winner.
This kind of win establishes him to the world.
An important win for him in this one.
Balor Club Rejoice, your leader has emerged victorious.
Oh, here come the men near the head of the table.
The following contest is a tag team match scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring at a combined weight of 479 pounds. The Raw Tag Team Champions, Jimmy and Jay.
Back early in their career, they were held down by some very, well, bad managers. But they've managed to grow through the years to become one of the all-time greats.
Sons of WWE Hall of Famer Rikishi, Jimmy and Jay, one of the most exciting teams of this generation.
Pounds. Dolph Ziggler and Robert Roode, Dirty Dogs.
A duo that always delivers when it comes to tag team action, and the WWE Universe is ready for it.
Team bout, it's gonna be Jimmy Uso and Jey Uso, and in the other corner they will be dealing with Dolph Ziggler and Bobby Roode.
These teams have scouted each other very well. They probably identified the weak link in their opposition, likely gonna want to isolate and punish that single individual.
I guess that's one way to incite your opponent.
Nasty right hand answers with an enziguri, crashing to the floor.
Look out, double leg drop.
Two.
Big impact off the leg drop.
Three.
Wow, what a leg drop. He catches Jimmy with a counter.
Back elbow smash, nothing fancy.
Back in under the ropes.
Take a good look at a real-life Titan, folks.
Lands face first.
Fireman's carry.
Nice takedown.
Incredible magnificence.
Here he comes off the tag.
What's coming next?
Look at him. Pride and poise personified.
Ooh. Oh, what a punch.
That's how you stop your opponent.
Getting him into the corner.
Torturous focus on the leg.
That could cause long-term damage.
Executed suplex.
And what a reversal from Jey Uso.
That hurt.
Suplex. Here it comes.
Nicely done.
Got Gotta find a way to get out of this.
Targeting the throat there.
Producing a trembling stiff kick.
Ooh, that might have just broken something.
Now he's been put on the defensive.
Here's a tag, and I don't think this is going to be good for their opponent, Corey.
Absolutely not. Up they go.
Oh,
he can pin his opponent right here. Gets the shoulder up and one.
He's not letting fatigue set in or get the better of it.
Oh, yeah.
Let's just all take a moment to truly appreciate and embrace his presence.
Yes, tag. Jawbreaker.
Call it down.
Just carrying the opposition anywhere they want. Oh, man, taking it to the trachea.
That's a good way to make the presence felt.
Oh, that'll break his arm. Vicious. He's certainly lining him up. This could do it. And he gets his shoulder up before the count.
Just using the adrenaline to stay in the match. We're no closer to a winner just yet.
Drops the elbow. The mark.
Jimmy tied that one.
And Dolph got bottled up there.
Uh-oh.
Oh, target in the arm. This is...
And now he's giving you all another chance to simply take it all in.
He's got it.
Oh, let's get it on.
Whatever's playing here can't be good.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, impressive counter. He's in, under the ropes.
Oh, right to the kidneys.
Golly.
He is just reeling from that offense.
These two teams have gone to war, Cole. Of course they're gonna wind up with a few battle scars.
Tag made. Oh, right to the gut.
Man, oh, man.
Nice takedown. Basement drop kick. No, that'll break his arm. Vicious.
He may be in a bad way here. This is what the purpose of a tag team is. Don't be afraid to use the resources and help your partner offers. Am I being diplomatic enough, Cole?
Down to Bowden, and a double axe handle smash.
From behind.
Back suplex. Delivers an axe handle.
He is a sight to behold. Take a picture while you can, everyone.
To the middle. Oh, super kick
on the mark.
Nice counter by Ziggler. Boom! What a drop kick.
On the mark.
Uh-huh. This DDT.
I thought for sure this thing was wrapped up.
Well, stay in your seat. Looks like we've got a ways to go yet.
I've lost count of how many times this match should have ended by now.
That's gotta be it.
Two count. He stopped the count for his partner. And here is Jey Uso forced out of the ring.
Hazardous position as Jimmy gains his footing.
Jey Uso looking incredibly exhausted.
Not what you want to see by any top rope.
So splash!
Will Jimmy seal this up?
Two! There's the drop! He's got the victory! And here's another quick look at those superstars in action in that tag team battle.
Jimmy and Jey, the Usos!
Jimmy Uso and company with the win.
This right pairing can certainly do wonders, and make no mistake, this was a wonderful performance tonight.
One of the tallest competitors in WWE history.
The personification of intimidation. The Colossus has arrived.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, accompanied by MVP from Lagos, Nigeria, weighing in at 400 pounds.
You want to talk about how dominant Omos has been already in his WWE career? This is a man who won the Raw Tag Team titles in his debut match, which took place at WrestleMania.
And in the days since, Omos has scored major wins against superstars the caliber of Riddle, even his former tag team partner, the phenomenal AJ Styles.
Towers over the entire locker room, both literally and figuratively.
Who in the world can take down this colossus known as Omos?
For Bobby Lashley, business is always good.
And his opponent from Colorado Springs, Colorado, weighing in at 273 pounds, the almighty Bobby Lashley.
A truly astounding physical specimen, military trained, countless amateur accolades, and a dominant MMA career.
Bobby Lashley has wasted very little time putting every other WWE superstar on notice.
Bobby Lashley is all about discipline. The son of a United States drill sergeant, former serviceman himself.
High impact personified.
And Corey, what do you you say to describe this man, Omos?
Well, words fail me, Cole, and that does not happen often. A legit 7-footer, 400 pounds, can move like a cheetah and has the natural power of a bulldozer. One of the most astonishing men walking God's green earth.
Very young in his professional career as Omos, but with the abilities he possesses, the sky is truly the limit.
And with Bobby Lashley facing him, you know Lashley only has one thing in mind, keeping business open by wrecking shop.
If Lashley is able to go about his preferred way of handling,
soaring! Splash!
Quickly, the cover.
One, two.
No, he pops the shoulder before three.
He's determined to keep this matchup going.
Ooh, well measured.
Vicious. Reversal on Lashley.
Oh, you can tell he's feeling it now. This fight is pumping him up.
Gutbuster
across the shoulder.
Filthy. Lashley is just a punishing force.
Lashley possesses such a dangerous arsenal.
It almost doesn't matter who he's facing. This has got to be a walk in the park for Omos, right?
Well, you'd think that, but here's the thing. Omos is still very, very new to WWE, and his natural ability is only going to take you so far. He needs to use what brought him to the dance, but underestimating a veteran opponent is a recipe for humiliation Omos wants to avoid.
Powerbomb!
Yeah.
Lashley just got out of there.
Saw that one coming, took advantage.
Thunderous clothesline.
Powerless position to be in right now.
Huge toss.
Archer rack applied, this could be it.
Strength of the giant. Cover.
Two.
Oh, a two count to kick out again.
As close to three as you could possibly get without the bell ringing.
Check out this power. Hoist it up. These superstars put on quite a show. Here's another look.
Here is your winner, the Almighty Bobby Lashley.
And that seemed like a pretty easy day at the office right there.
Never a doubt. Barely a moment's suspense. This one was about as lopsided as they come.
The Apex Predator has arrived.
One of the all-time greats has seen and done everything there is to do in this business.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 250 pounds, the Viper, Randy Orton!
Think of all the legendary factions that Randy Orton has been a part of. All steps in his career greatness.
He learned from the best.
But at a very early age, Randy proved he can go it alone.
Yeah, we learned very quickly that Randy Orton was the student who was able to surpass the masters.
And in the process, Randy Orton has become a master in his own right.
One of the most vindictive, one of the most vengeful, and one of the most dangerous superstars you will ever see.
That's why I love everything about this guy, Saxton.
Such an impressive array of in-ring skills possessed by the Viper.
All Randy Orton needs is one RKO to end your evening.
Well, Byron, I guarantee you Orton's gonna show us tonight that he's much more than that.
Yeah, Randy Orton is an SOB.
The ultimate opportunist.
And his opponent, accompanied by the Glamazon Beth Phoenix from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 249 pounds, the Rated R Superstar, Edge!
Who can forget the incredible comeback story of Edge, who entered number one and outlasted every competitor to win the 2021 Royal Rumble.
Triumphant return to in-ring action. It should have been a moment of celebration, but Randy Orton just couldn't pass up a chance to pick a fight with his once close friend.
Orton thought Edge was being foolish, trying to come back to the ring after all that time. He said it was his job.
He could pin his opponent right here. Gets his shoulder up before the two count.
Channeling his energy to stay in this matchup.
Edge with the alertness there.
Power slam. Edge caught him there. Just stomping down. Oh, right to the kidneys.
Golly.
You know, both Orton and Edge wield explosive moves that can come out of nowhere and devastate opponents. The RKO and the spear. It'll be very interesting to see which one proves more effective in this matchup.
I agree, Corey. Whoever is able to find those openings to launch their big attack will be primed to take complete control of this matchup.
Aggression, just pure brutality.
Come on, easy.
From the top. Oh, that elbow drop. Here's a cover.
One, two.
And he powers out.
You have to think this match is starting to take its toll.
Evading offense.
A knee right to the face.
That knee is a lethal weapon.
Going right after the neck.
Neck breaker.
Edge bringing the attack to Orton with incredible force.
He can end it here.
One, two.
And a kick out at two.
And frustration might be starting to set in.
A Rated R Superstar with a Diamond Spear.
That just put down the Viper.
Two count.
He kicks out somehow.
That was amazing. Orton is still in this.
The Viper still has a lot of fight left in him.
And Edge's shell shot. He thought that was the crushing blow he needed.
Bang. Snap suplex.
This is not where Edge wants to be.
In control here with a swinging neck breaker.
Textbook.
Well, that'll do some serious damage. He could pin his opponent right here.
It's over.
Strong kick out late into the match.
Look at the look on his opponent's face, Cole. He can't believe it.
Oh, and a clothesline to follow.
Edge could end it there.
Is it enough? The cover. Edge did it. Edge did it. Now's a good time to look at some of the highlights from that last matchup.
Your winner, the Rated R Superstar, Edge!
After an intense match, it's Edge who gets to walk away the winner. It took absolutely everything Edge had to get the victory over his old friend, Randy Orton.
Well, facing the Apex Predator demands the very best of you in the ring, but I think the person...
Gentlemen, we are about to experience something phenomenal.
Here's a man who can do it all and has done it all in short order here in WWE.
Maybe the greatest in-ring competitor of this generation.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Gainesville, Georgia, weighing in at 218 pounds, the phenomenal AJ Styles!
Always on the hunt for glory.
He is the consummate in-ring competitor.
AJ Styles is a great competitor, but hardly professional.
Come on, Byron, you can't argue with AJ's success.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. The visionary, the revolutionary Seth freaking Rollins has arrived.
Well, certainly Seth Rollins has unmatched accolades, a championship resume, but a wardrobe that leaves a lot to be desired.
Saxton, last time you saw that much drip, you called a plumber.
And his opponent from Davenport, Iowa, weighing in at 217 pounds, Seth Rollins.
So he's been called the Kingslayer, right? The architect, the Messiah. How about we give him a new nickname, Mr. Delusional?
Oh, bite your tongue, Cole. There is nothing delusional about this man. Seth Rollins has earned everything. It just happens that everyone else is jealous.
Multiple Universal and WWE title reigns. He's won the Royal Rumble and Money in the Bank.
You know, there was a time when Seth Rollins used to feed off the energy of the WWE Universe. Now he's just happy celebrating all of his accomplishments alone.
Seth Rollins vowed that AJ Styles will not walk out of here tonight.
Scary words from Rollins, who likes to pride himself on being a man of his word.
And these men know the buzz in the atmosphere whenever they collide. But tonight's about winning and cementing a legacy. If Seth needs to take an extreme measure, he'll do just that. Look out! Oh, God. Absolutely throwing all caution to the wind.
Spitting in the face of danger.
Ooh, well-planted knee.
Ouch.
Whoa! The height on the moonsault.
What a knee strike from the Kingslayer.
AJ with the wherewithal to avoid that.
Big forearm.
Rollins and Styles both took similar paths to get to WWE. They know one another extremely well. How can Seth capitalize on that?
Well, they have similar careers, yes, but Rollins has a slight edge in big match experience. That experience gives him adaptability in stressful situations. I don't know if I can say the same for Styles.
What separates Rollins from the rest is his ability to remain cerebral as the pace increases. Boom! A gut buster! AJ Styles.
And what a reversal from Seth Rollins.
Yeah.
Seth Rollins. Call super kick.
This could stop AJ Styles for a while. Oh, that'll break his arm. Vicious.
Oh, my goodness.
Nasty right hand. Enziguri to the floor.
No way.
Oh, God. That's a bad landing.
No, that was a harebrained idea to try that.
Was trying to find a way to attack, but two. Completely wiped out. To truly appreciate and embrace his presence.
Oh, God, what a brainbuster.
He could do it here.
Two.
Gets the shoulder up. Not yet.
Answering back.
Styles a step ahead. Rollins dodges in the nick of time.
He's on his heels a bit now.
There's been plenty of action in this match, and the cost of that is really showing now.
Oh, that's how you establish dominance.
What is this superstar waiting for here? Their opponent can't even stand.
He moved.
but can he capitalize?
Right to the kidneys from behind. No.
Here we go.
Inverted DDT.
Lights out.
Coming next.
AJ finds the mark.
Will it pay off for Styles?
Cover. One, two, three.
AJ Styles gets the win.
We've got some highlights from the last one queued up. Here we go.
Your winner, the Phenomenal AJ Styles.
A major win for AJ Styles. Took down Rollins with the precision of a sniper.
AJ Styles came in with a gigantic chip on his shoulder in regards to Seth Rollins. I don't think that chip's going away.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 295 pounds, Brock Lesnar!
Emotionless, heartless, and hell-bent on absolute destruction. That, my friends, is the beast incarnate, Brock Lesnar.
I've talked to a lot of superstars who have faced Brock Lesnar, and there is one common denominator between them all. They say once you are in the ring with Brock Lesnar, you are never the same.
Because you go to Suplex City!
This just became the KO show.
And his opponent, from Marieville, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 266 pounds, Kevin Owens!
Kevin Owens used to fight for himself and his family. Now he fights against authority and everything Shane McMahon stands for.
A Universal Champion, a United States Champion, the list goes on, and Kevin Owens owes it all to himself.
Corey, what is
it mean to be in the ring with the Beast incarnate?
Simply put, Cole, it means doom for any athlete across from him.
You might not be far off. When Lesnar goes on the offense, there's little that can slow the Beast down.
And across the way is Kevin Owens, a competitor who gets in the ring and just goes to work. For KO, this match might as well just be another day at the office.
Well, this is Kevin Owens' livelihood. His number one priority is putting food on the table for his family. But don't let that fool you into thinking he's just clocking in and clocking out. Kevin Owens will do whatever it takes to make sure his family is very well taken care of. And the top!
Oh, look at that splash!
Shoulders down!
In sight. You doing here, Corey? And the ropes break this one up.
Great ring awareness there.
Double leg.
Lesnar moved.
Big forearm.
Headlock applied, toss their opponent. Carefully placed stomp to the arm.
Tagged with a punch. Tough position to be caught in here. Down on the windpipe. Oh, that'll break his arm. Vicious.
Is firing on all cylinders. The Beast is unleashing his fury in the ring.
This is the level of destruction the Beast, and he can end it here.
He's got him.
One, two.
Oh, and a kick out. Kicked out. He kicked out.
I thought for sure he was done.
Owens intercepts it. Uncorks a thunderous chop.
Oh, neck breaker.
Good hands.
That was nasty.
Shoulders down.
One,
kicks out.
Really had less than a second to stay alive there. Lesnar rolls him off. The scary thing is, this is ordinary for the Beast incarnate. It's going to take a lot more to keep Lesnar down for the count.
And Owens is stunned. Thought he'd done enough to end it, but he was wrong.
This is how far KO is willing to go, to put himself on the line to put food.
Stunner!
Can that finish the Beast off?
It was an awesome win for this young man.
One of the biggest in his career by far.
What a battle. Respect to both competitors.
And this I love. This I absolutely love. Maybe you should have taken a page out of that kid's book in your career, Corey. Great sportsmanship.
I would have hit him in the mouth.